When I walk on by, girls be looking like they be fly. I pick to the beat, walking down the street in my new freak, yeah. This is how I roll, animal print pants out of control. It's Red Bull with the big ass bra, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
Hey guys, I hope everyone likes the video clips of the FPV car, and this is a walkthrough on how to build it. To be honest, this whole process took me around 40 hours to do. There's a lot of multiple research on multiple platforms that I personally think has not been done before, so it's a lot harder. But hopefully with this build, you can finish it in maybe 5-10 hours. So over here, we have the Losi Lasernut, really good rock crawler. And this system is very special because it uses an actual car controller remote and very hard to configure it, but we're gonna go through everything to make it so much easier for you guys, okay?
Okay, so I'm gonna explain what has been modified in this car. So as you see here, we'll start with the battery. So the battery that I'm using right now is the 8400 milliamps 120C4S. Very large battery, you could travel for very far. You could probably get an hour, maybe an hour and a half of driving through this. So it's a bit of an overkill, but why not, right? And then down the list over here is the V-Fly buzzer. So what that does is that if someone steals your system, and you want to turn the alarm on, then you could, and then it'll just start beeping, and then you know that everything will be safe on your side. I'm gonna show the description over here. And now, instead of the system, the engine system with a cooling system, so the fan that I'm using up here, and up here, over here to cool the air unit, is the 40 millimeter, not too fans, like computer fans. It is a bit of a work because you have to solder it to a JST plug, but they're super, super solid. And with the air unit, it does record sound. Therefore, it's good to have low power, silent fans so that you could hear the unit. So let's see. So over here, you see here, we have the Speedybee flight controller. So this thing is powered by a balance port, and the balance port goes into the battery on the side as a 4S. It works really well. It goes up to, I think, 3S to 6S, so it can definitely power it. There's a capacitor for in case if there's any issues. The good thing about this system, with the DJI system, is that you see here there's a plug here. That will plug in directly into the air unit over here without any soldering, so that makes life a lot easier. And then as you see in the back here, we have a GPS unit. It's the BN200. I'll show the description over here. And for the flight controller over here, here's the prices. They're all in Canadian prices, okay? So with this, there is a little wire over here. And then I drilled a hole on the bottom, goes directly into this, and then it's soldered directly here. So I'm gonna show you the image of how to solder it. It's very small, so you do need some soldering skills for it. but it is definitely doable. If you are using Betaflight or the Speedybee app, which I think works pretty much the same thing, I don't know if it's exactly the same, but it works exactly the same. Remember to use UART1. So it's very important to use UART1 because that's where everything is connected, okay? And then you have to start doing the actual programming, but I'll explain all the programming and all the software later. I'm just explaining all the hardware that I've done. As you see here, the camera is connected to the gimbal here, so there's the head tracking function, and the camera is connected to the air unit right here. The air unit does get hot, so you definitely want to have a fan. There's a hole drilled inside here and blows directly to the air unit. If you are stationary, if there's no fan, it'll overheat and it'll damage the air unit. So very important to add a fan. And then over here, so we have the MMCX wires connected extenders on the top here, so that you could have the antennas up here. So antenna is very important because it increases the signal, omnidirectional, all that crap. So it makes it a lot better. And remember, you want to MMCX and then with the to the RP SMA, and that should come in a female. So MMCX to female, and then connected to this, which is the matchsticks from True RC. Here's the description for those, and then to the wire, and to the air unit, I guess. And then afterwards, with these matchsticks, it increases the range. Other modification that I did was that with the mirrors here, they're functional, they're fully functional. So you could move the camera here, like when you turn your head, you can see the reflection here, and it will see it on the back. Just some really cool tweaks that I've made. And then of course I added a backlight here, so when you're driving, you want people to see your car so that it lights up in red. And then as you see here, this is the actual receiver controller. So I'm gonna flip this over and open this up again. I don't know if you can see this, but over here is the receiver. And then we have channel 7 to power all the other powers, lights, and all the good stuff. And then it's 5 and 6 for the bag system, which I'll show you how to program later. And then, so this remote, it's only $100. I'll show the description over here. But then it comes with the receiver. And remember to use conforming compounds to waterproof all the units. So spray it or put it on, whatever you do, always put it on. And it comes with two wires, and the two wires actually comes in here and then goes out over here. So just to maximum range. And remember, for the antenna, always try to make the 90-degree angle because the signals, you want it to be opposite so you get the maximum signal range. So I'm gonna explain here how this system works. So this is the FPV goggles. There's several upgrades here. So there is the flight crystal front side for the bottom antennas. And the top ones are the True RC stubbies. So I'll show the descriptions here and there. And over here we have the head tracker unit from Motion Sick. Very, very awesome. It tracks your left, right, everything works perfectly. It has all the 3D printed stuff that you need. And then it connects, there's this power splitter. And then of course it connects it into the, the headphone jack over here so that the system could control, like could communicate. So what I'm gonna do next is to show you how what to program.
Very importantly, remember to change your DSC and then make it into either two axle track or three axle track. I haven't found the difference yet, but remember to change that mode from simulator. It is good to change the gyro setting to VR so that you can program this with the knob over here to change the amount of gyro that you want in the car. To make things a little bit more complicated, I put the 3 switch. So when you switch to central, the throttle goes 40. And when you go up, it goes 100. And when you go all the way down, it's 25.
So it's great for if you want to let your friend try the FPV, but you don't want to trash it. You give them 25% power at first so that it's a little bit safer. I would also turn the ABS on so that when you brake really hard, the car doesn't flip over, just to protect the FPV system. To link the goggles into the air unit, you see this little hole over here? You have to double tap it and hold it for 3 seconds. And then afterwards, you have to go to the air unit, and it would be initially green color, or should be. And then when you hit on the reset button once in the hole over here, then it becomes red and it should auto connect together.
So over here we have the Speedybee flight controller app, pretty much similar to beta flight, and it didn't find any differences. So after you connect, I'll go page by page. Let's see here. So for the ports, remember to use UART1 for the DJI head unit. That's what the port uses for the cable. And then for UART6, make sure you put on GPS if you do connect to the GPS for the 4-5 volts and all the good stuff. Over here, we have the telemetry. You turn it on. What else? You don't have to do anything here because we are using a car remote. Over here, you could personalize it with the car name. I put FPV RC Car. We put the GPS, U-blocks, auto-config, auto-detect. Put display on, air mode, OSD, soft serial. All the other stuff, it's just optional, I think. OSD, so this is the actual OSD you want on the screen. So I just put the telemetry for the speed, the battery, and all the good stuff. I think it's really good information. That's why I've left it on. The GPS speed. I think that's pretty much it. So for the OSD, it's a little bit more complicated if you want to have a display on the goggles. So firstly, you gotta go to the DJI app to make sure, see what kind of version you have for the goggles. Then if you don't have the 100.08 or something like that, then you have to downgrade the firmware in order to root the WTFFPV website here. So as you see here, you can change the OSD overlay later once you have everything set up. But more importantly, you would want to go to update and then install, and then you got to root the device. And once you have rooted it, then you can actually go into the actual package manager right here. So once you click on that, then you could change it to the first. Do the mod for the 1200 milliwatts, so increase the power of the unit. And the second thing you want to click on is the OSD. So once you click on those, in theory, it should work. After you update the air unit also, and then of course you have to do the CLI codes. So there's a lot of tutorials that you could look for online to kind of complete this step.
Alright guys, thanks for watching the walkthrough for the FPV RC car. I hope the video was helpful, and if you liked the video, please like, subscribe, and comment. Special thanks for Motion Sick. They helped me to kind of guide me how to start. And of course, Chad FPV, so the description will be here and there. Take a look at the channel, they're very cool too. And if you guys have any questions, just leave me a comment and I'll try my best to help.